According to some estimates, we cannot track $2.3 trillion in transactions.
$2.3 trillion with a T. That's $8,000 for every man, woman, and child in America. To understand how the Pentagon can lose track of trillions, consider the case of one military accountant who tried to find out what happened to a mere 300 million.
We know it's gone, but we don't know what they spent it on.
Jim Minnery, a former Marine turned whistleblower, is risking his job by speaking out for the first time.
The director looked at me and he said, "Why do you care about this stuff?"
He was reassigned and says officials then covered up the problem by just writing it off.
Terrifying only begins to describe the problem. The Department of Defense's own Inspector General report for fiscal year 1999 noted that the Defense Finance and Accounting Service had processed $7.6 trillion of department-level accounting entries in that year. Of that amount, only $3.5 trillion could be properly accounted for. $2.3 trillion in transactions were fudged to make entries balance, run through without proper documentation, or made up entirely. The Inspector General's office did not even examine the other $1.8 trillion in transactions because they did not have adequate time or staff to review them. In 2002, one DFAS accountant blew the whistle on the problem and the cover-up that was underway to stop investigators from finding out where the money went. The attack on the Pentagon struck Wedge 1 on the west side of the building. An office of the U.S. Army called Resource Services Washington had just moved back into Wedge 1 after renovations had taken place there. The office was staffed with 45 accountants, bookkeepers, and budget analysts. 34 of them were killed in the attack. A 2002 follow-up report from the DOD Inspector General on the missing trillions noted that a further $1.1 trillion in made-up accounting entries were processed by the Pentagon in fiscal year 2000, but they did not even attempt to quantify the missing funds for 2001. The Secretary of the Army, Thomas White, later explained they were unable to produce a financial report for 2001 at all due to the loss of financial management personnel sustained during the September 11th terrorist attack. Before becoming Secretary of the Army, Thomas White was a senior executive at Enron. Enron was one of the largest energy companies in the world, posting a $111 billion profit in 2000 before being exposed as an elaborate corporate accounting fraud in 2001. The SEC, which investigated the Enron scandal, occupied the 11th to 13th floors in World Trade Center Building 7, and their offices were destroyed on 9/11, destroying 3,000 to 4,000 documents on active investigations in the process. By 2013, the unaccountable money in the Pentagon's coffers had reached $8.5 trillion. There are at least 8.5 trillion reasons to investigate the money trail of 9/11.